chunks are not eaten directly. Instead, they are used by the very smallest minim workers to cultivate a nutritious fungus. The ants' activities outside the nest have not gone unnoticed. They are being watched. The most accessible leaves are located to the north of the nest entrance. However, another attic colony has already laid claim to them. The close proximity of these nests places the two colonies in direct competition with one another. Time will tell which has the potential to grow into a great empire, and which will submit to the unforgiving law of the undergrowth. These rove beetle larvae are distant relatives of the European devil's coach horse. Despite a few million years of separation, they share the same carnivorous appetite, razor-sharp pincers, and most importantly, a fearsome final form. Thank you. The leaf cutters have raised their first major ant. Its swollen head is filled with muscle to power its crushing jaws. Few stand against it in combat and escape unscathed. This champion warrior will make a fine addition to the colony. As the sun sets below the horizon and the thick rainforest canopy shrouds all but the slightest glimmer of moonlight, the predators of the night begin to emerge.
Thank you.
One of the ants has fallen prey to a young, leaf-mimic praying mantis. Once in range, its long, razor-clad forelegs can ensnare and impale victims with lightning speed. Daybreak has arrived, and the creatures of the night scurry back to the dark crevices of the undergrowth. For the ants, however, the objectives of the day remain unchanged. Locate vegetation, defend supply lines, and process leaves. There is no time for rest. Thank you. The ants must defend themselves. These leaves are contested. The leaf cutters will generally not attack unless provoked, but today there's too much at stake. Only a strong show of force will deter the opposing colony. Opposing leaf cutters have retreated from one of their harvesting sites. They may have been easily startled this time, but they'll soon be back, and in greater numbers. The battle has begun. The battle has begun. The leafcutters have secured a vital harvesting site from their opponents. Night falls, and under the cloak of darkness, velvet worms, bush crickets, and harvestmen emerge from their hiding places. Any ant straying from the relative safety of the trail will likely meet with an unfortunate end. A territorial dispute has arisen between the Atta colonies. An ant has fallen prey to a wandering harvestman. Its long, slender legs keep its vulnerable body elevated high above the leaf litter. And when threatened, it can release strong-smelling odors to deter other predators. A stern response will be needed to drive this striding nuisance away. The opposing Atta colony has retreated from one of its sites to the northwest, leaving unguarded foliage ripe for the picking. Leafcutters aren't the only ants nearby. Whilst the two Atta colonies joust for territory, Odontomachus bowery trap jaws roam the clearing. They can be found hunting alone or in small packs for vulnerable invertebrates to take back to their nest. They use snapping jaws to bludgeon their targets, exerting 300 times their body weight in a single blow. Thank you. The battle has begun. A Paracanthus varius bush cricket has spotted the ants. Its thorax and appendages are adorned with sharp protruding spikes, offering 360 degrees of protection and turning its substantial forelegs into a pair of deadly flails. This spiny devil will not easily be deterred. The leafcutters have clashed northeast of the nest. Opposing leafcutters have been cleared from an area to the northeast. Harvesting operations can now continue. As the sun rises over the treetops above, the diurnal jungle invertebrates emerge once again to replace their nighttime counterparts. The ants will remain steadfast in their efforts. All must be risked for the harvest. A brightly patterned jumping spider, Cercaspheri D. purpureus, has subdued one of the workers. This expert solo hunter combines extreme agility with incredible forward vision, allowing it to pounce on unsuspecting prey with pinpoint accuracy. A fight has broken out over the harvesting rights to a sapling. Opposing leafcutters have been cleared from an area to the northeast. Harvesting operations can now continue. Overwhelmed by the defensive leafcutter forces, the harvestman decides to make a swift exit. The ants have subdued their rivals and achieved dominion over the clearing. As the competition withers, they will extend their territory in all directions, firmly establishing their agricultural empire. One day, this colony will number in the millions. Another squad of leafcutter mages are inbound. The hillside adders must gain control. Predators are loose in the nest. The larvae must be protected. There are intruders in the nest. Thank you. chance will fight to the death. More leaf cutters are inbound. The ants must fight. Dusk approaches. As the twilight fades, the daytime creatures withdraw to their hidden refuges to wait out the darkness. The ants can afford no such luxury. The cogs of the leafcutter machine will grind on throughout the night. A fight has broken out over the harvesting rights to a sapling. Predators are loose in the nest. The larvae must be protected. The opposing Atta colony has retreated from one of its sites to the northwest, leaving unguarded foliage ripe for the picking. More leaf cutters are inbound. there are intruders in the nest. The ants must defend themselves. The leafcutters have clashed northeast of the nest.